Welcome to e-learning course on basic thermodynamics session temperature concepts, scales and measurements. Myself Ramesh Bhair, assistant professor in the department of mechanical engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davangere. To start with temperature concepts, we first discuss the basics of temperature measurement and what is a governing law of thermodynamics behind temperature measurement, which is zeroth law of thermodynamics. Zeroth law of thermodynamics is the basis of temperature measurement. The statement given for zeroth law of thermodynamics is that when a body A is in thermal equilibrium with body B and also separately with body C, then the body B and C will be in thermal equilibrium with each other. It can also be stated in otherwise, when two bodies have equality of temperature with third body, then they are in turn have equality of temperature with each other. So these are the two statements given for zeroth law of thermodynamics. So next is equality of temperature. Two systems are equal in temperature if no change occurs in any property when they are in brought into communication. If that is the case, you can say the system are in equality of temperature. Further, we see temperature, we define temperature. So temperature is defined as an intensive property which is independent of size and mass of the system. So it is precisely defined as degree of hotness or coldness of a body or an environment or a driving force or potential causing the flow of energy as heat or measure of mean kinetic energy of the molecules of a system or parameter which determines whether or not a system is in thermal equilibrium. So these are the different forms of defining the temperature. Next is thermometry. Thermometry may be defined as the act of measuring temperature with accuracy and precision. So zeroth law is the basis of temperature measurement. So in order to obtain a quantitative measure of temperature, a reference body called as a reference body is used where a physical characteristics are selected and which are called as thermometric property, and the reference body which is used in determination of temperature will be called as a thermometer. So thermometer is the reference body and the physical characteristics of that thermometer will be the measurement of temperature. So you can see one of the pictorial represent of temperature measurement here. So we have two reference temperatures. One is 0 degree, which is at ice point, and 100 degree at steam point. And normally certain amount of divisions will be made between 0 degree and 100 degree Celsius. As in Celsius scale, 100 divisions are made. And here the thermometric property is the length, which is a physical characteristics of the reference body. Moving further, so one of the example for temperature measurements are, that is mercury in glass thermometer, which is a common thermometer which consists of a small amount of mercury which is placed in an evacuated capillary tube. This is an evacuated capillary tube. In the extension of mercury in the tube is used as a thermometric property. So whatever the extension, this extension of mercury in the capillary tube will be measured. It will be the measurement of temperature. And there are five different kinds of thermometers with its own thermometric properties as below. So before that, so these thermometers are calibrated based on some of the relations which are used. So when it is directly proportional, we are going to use the expression T is equal to AX, where T is the temperature measure, A is the constant of thermometer or the device, and X is the physical characteristics. And when the relation is linear, we are going to use T is equal to AX plus B, and A and B are constant. X is thermometric property, which is a physical characteristics. And if it is a quadratic relation, we will go for T is equal to AX square plus BX plus C. And if it is a polynomial relationship, we will go for T is equal to A plus BX plus CX square plus DX cube. And the constants appearing in these relations can be determined from any two fixed thermometric proper points, example ice point and steam point. And we have different kinds of thermometers with thermometric properties mentioned in the table. So the thermometers are constant volume gas thermometer, which will have a pressure as thermometric property, and constant pressure gas thermometer will have volume as thermometric property. Electrical resistance thermometer will have resistance as thermometric property, and the fourth one, which is a thermocouple, will have thermal EMF as thermometric property. And the last one is mercury in glass thermometer, where the length will be the thermometric property. And using these thermometric properties, we are going to find out the temperature. Further, we now see one by one the different kinds of thermometers. In that, the first one is a gas thermometer. So there are two types of gas thermometers. One is constant volume and constant pressure. So a quantitative measurement of temperature of a system requires a reference to some datum point or reference condition, and the same is established using suitable temperature unit. So many temperature scales and reference points have been proposed. So the important one are discussed in this topic. So a schematic diagram of constant volume as well as constant pressure gas thermometer is given in figure. There will be a small amount of gas enclosed in the bulb here, bulb which is in communication via the capillary tube with one limb of the mercury manometer is open to the atmosphere, and one limb is connected to the capillary tube. The pressure in the bulb will be the measurement of thermometry property, or it will be the measurement of temperature. The pressure in the bulb is expressed based on thermometric property as of that. P is equal to P naught plus rho mg h. So h is the rise of mercury in the one of the limb, and P naught is the pressure acting on the mercury on the limb which is open to the atmosphere, and P is a thermometric property of the gas which is measured. So where P naught represents atmospheric pressure and rho m represents the density of the mercury. So when the bulb is brought in contact with the system whose temperature has to be measured, here bath or the environment temperature to be measured, the bulb in the course of time comes in thermal equilibrium with the system. The gas in the bulb expands on being heated, pushing the mercury down on one of the limb downward, The flexible limb of the mercury is then adjusted so that the mercury again touches the lip on one of the limb. The difference in mercury level, which is H, is recorded, and the pressure of the gas in the bulb is estimated using the equation P is equal to P naught plus rho m g H. And based on that, here we are going to define, or we are going to find out the temperature, as the volume is trapped in the setup is constant. Then from ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to mRT, so we can finally write delta T is equal to V over R into delta P, so which is named as equation 2. Here we can observe temperature increase is proportional to pressure increase. As the pressure increases in the bulb, so there will be an increase in temperature. That is a observation what we can make with the help of equation number 2, as that delta T is equal to V over R multiplied by delta P. So in this case, volume is constant and the gas constant is also constant. So constant over constant becomes constant. So equal to constant, equal and constant is taken as proportional symbol or proportional. So finally we can say that increase in temperature is proportional to increase in pressure. Similarly, in constant pressure gas thermometer, so pressure is maintained constant and volume will changes. So change in volume is measured with the help of a manometer by measuring the increase in mercury level in one of the limb. So based on ideal gas equation, what we can write, delta T is equal to P over R multiplied with delta V. And it is similar to previous case, that is equation 2. So what we can observe here, the temperature increase is proportional to observed volume. So here in a constant pressure gas thermometer, the mercury level has to be adjusted to keep H value constant, not the limb of the value L. In constant volume case, we supposed to maintain the level of mercury in one of the limb at point A, or here with respect to this figure at point O. But in constant pressure case, so H value is maintained constant from O to this point is maintained constant. To maintain that constant, the movement of one of the limb is made up and down, and which makes the volume, pressure constant inside the bulb. When the bulb is brought in contact with the system whose temperature is to be measured, in course of a time it reaches thermal equilibrium condition. So the gas in the bulb expands, being heated, pushing mercury. The flexible limb of the manometer is used to maintain H value constant by moving up and down. As the volume of the gas is constant, we can finally write delta T is equal to P by R delta V. So from this, what we can observe, finally temperature increase is proportional to observed volume increase. And next is International Practical Temperature Scale. So which was adopted during 7th General Conference on Weights and Measures held in 1927. It was not to replace the Celsius or ideal gas scales, but to provide an experimental basis scale that can be easily and rapidly used to calibrate scientific and industrial instruments to indicate temperatures as close as possible to the Kelvin thermodynamic scale. The International Practical Scale agrees with Celsius scale at the defining fixed points as listed below in the table. So fixed points are temperature of equilibrium between liquid and vapor oxygen, which is named as oxygen point, which is at a temperature of -182.97 degrees Celsius. And the second fixed point is temperature of equilibrium between ice and air saturated water, which is called as ice point, which is taken as 0.000 degrees Celsius. And the third fixed point is between liquid water and its vapor, that is steam point, which is at 100.000 degrees Celsius. And the fourth one is liquid sulfur and its vapor, that is sulfur point. The temperature is 444.600 degrees Celsius. And temperature of equilibrium between solid and liquid silver, which is silver point, at a value of 960.800 degrees Celsius. And the last fixed point was temperature of equilibrium between solid and liquid gold, that is gold point, which is at 1063.000 degrees Celsius. So these are some of the fixed points which has been adopted in coordination with Celsius K, or which agrees with the Celsius K in defining the fixed points. So for interpolation between these primary fixed points and numerous other secondary fixed points, a thermometer is specified with an equation to establish relationship between thermometric property and temperature, as we have discussed earlier. There are different possibilities are there, that is, if it is directly proportional, linearly, like that. So the method of evaluating constant in correlation is also specified. For example, so from -190 to 0 degrees Celsius, a platinum resistant thermometer with a platinum wire whose diameter must lie between 0.05 millimeter and 0.20 millimeter is used, and the temperature is defined by polynomial of the form R is equal to R naught into 1 plus AT plus BT square plus C into T minus 100 multiplied by T cube, where the constant R naught, A, B and C are computed by the measurements at the ice point, steam point and oxygen point respectively. Then from 0 to 660 degrees Celsius, a platinum resistance thermometer is used with the diameter between 0.05 millimeter to 0.20 millimeter. And a polynomial equation of the form R is equal to R naught into 1 plus AT plus BT square is used, where R naught, A and B are constants computed by the measurements made at ice point, steam point and sulfur point respectively. Then from 660 to 1063 degrees Celsius, a thermocouple of one wire made of platinum and other made of an alloy of 90% platinum and 10% rhodium is used, with one junction at 0 degrees Celsius and diameter ranging between 0.35 to 0.65 millimeter. And the polynomial equation used here is E is equal to A plus BT plus CT square, where A, B, C are the constants computed by the measurement at the antimony point, silver point and gold point respectively. And for optical methods which are used for the temperature ranges greater than 1063 degrees Celsius, adopted measuring the temperature higher than the gold point. So the intensity of radiation of any convenient wavelength is compared with the intensity of radiation of the same length emitted by a black body at the gold point in optical method, and the temperature is then determined with the help of Planck's law of thermal radiation. So this is a method which is adopted if the temperature measurement is made more than 1063 degree Celsius. And this is the end of session on concepts, scales and measurements related to temperature. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe to my channel BR Mech Academy.